Nothing is true. Everything is permitted. We work in the dark to serve the light. We are the assassins. While these quotes are from a different game series, they're no less unrelated to the ghosts who walk the path of the assassin. Loners by nature, the assassin is near unrivaled with their ability to deal death unseen. The skill of the assassin is not just to kill openly, but to be ready to land a definitive strike to finish off a foe at a moment's notice when the opportunity presents itself. Or, rather, when an opportunity is made. With that said, my name is Phantasm Gaming, and welcome to my beginner's guide on how to get started as the assassin in Ghost of Tsushima Legends. A quick disclaimer, at the time of recording this audio, I have only just started playing Nightmare Difficulty and I have not yet played the raids at this time, and I am primarily a Ronin main overall. However, I do have plenty of experience with all four classes, or at least enough to give you some basic tips and tricks, and as well as a basic idea of how to get started with each class. So in this case, the Assassin. For the uninitiated, what is the Assassin? Well, this class is just that, the Assassin. The Assassin is the stealth-focused class of the four ghost classes in Legends, and is in fact the one who comes the closest to actually being the Ghost, aka Jin Sakai, in terms of gameplay. His perks and abilities are all focused around stealth and dealing massive amounts of damage to single targets, with an ultimate that allows him to teleport insane distances and to strike at a foe from the shadows. Assassins also have the bonus of having some of the coolest looking masks in the game, and are the only class who can't use the majority of the masks you unlock in story mode for this very reason. Although, frankly, if we're being honest, some of these masks should definitely be in story mode. They're awesome. This class is the Opportunist, playing similarly to the other classes in melee combat while plodding away, waiting for just the right moment to vanish in a cloud of smoke to start backstabbing their foes to weed out the herd. Is it dishonorable? Probably. Will it make Uncle very disappointed in you? Very. But is it effective? Oh, you have no idea. Like the other three classes, the Assassin comes with a class ability on a cooldown that can be activated by pressing down the D-pad, and an ultimate that can be activated by pressing L1 R1 when you have 3 points of resolve. At later levels, you will also unlock a second class ability that can be swapped between with the first one, and a third ability that can be activated at the cost of a single point of resolve, so long as you have the appropriate perk selected. The first class ability is Toxic Vanish. This ability acts similar to a smoke bomb, where the assassin drops a bomb at his feet and turns invisible, instantly causing all enemies to lose sight of you and setting up for a quick sneak attack to insta-kill one of them, or, if they have a high enough amount of health, a critical strike that will take out a sizable chunk of said health. In addition, vanishing with this ability will also deal poison damage to all nearby enemies, which will drain their stamina over time and open them up for melee attacks from yourself or nearby allies. The second class ability is Group Vanish. This ability is functionally the same as Toxic Vanish, where the assassin turns invisible and sets up for a sneak attack. The difference here is that Group Vanish, aside from having a shorter cooldown than Toxic Vanish, will also turn nearby allies invisible along with you, meaning for a potential of a total of 4 sneak attacks at once, possibly 8 if you have the Chain Vanish perk and everyone can manage to kill their target. Well, and of course if they stay around you in time to refresh it. More on that later, though. Most teams I've come across generally seem preferred if you have Group Vanish over Toxic Vanish, and for good reason. Group Vanish is practically the only way the assassin can actually offer some support to his team without the use of a legendary weapon. The third ability you can unlock is Super Strike, and this is the perk one. For the cost of a single point of resolve, you can perform a stronger stealth attack that deals double damage of a normal one. To activate this, all you need to do is press triangle while in stealth, and mostly undetected. This ability is a fairly strong perk overall, allowing you to nearly one-shot Oni, or possibly finish them off while they still have a significant amount of health left. Keep in mind, though, that this does require a point of resolve to activate, so if you plan to use this, this will mean less frequent use of the next ability. And that ability is the ultimate, Shadow Strike. When activated, the assassin glows white and can press square to teleport to highlighted enemies and deliver a quick strike that will insta-kill weaker enemies and severely damage stronger ones. You can teleport to an enemy this way up to 3 times, unless you take the next perk, Shadow Storm. With the Shadow Storm perk, the number of teleports the assassin can do with his ultimate is increased by 2, meaning you have 5 total teleports, which means up to 5 enemies dead, potentially, if you can choose your targets wisely. This ultimate is functionally very similar to Hachiman's Fury for the Samurai, although not as fast in terms of how quickly it can deal damage. What Shadow Strike lacks in speed, though, it makes up for in versatility. You can teleport a surprisingly far distance to an enemy with this ultimate, making it a fantastic gap closer if you're running for a defense area currently overrun with enemies. You also have more control over who you actually attack, meaning you can pick and choose which targets to strike at. Do you focus all your attacks on the one Oni giving your team trouble, or do you take out some of the weaker mooks that are distracting your team from directly dealing with said Oni? There's far greater freedom of choice with this ultimate compared to Hachiman's Fury. With Hachiman, it's basically like the Dance of Wrath from Story Mode, where all you can do is, point your left control stick in the general direction of enemy and hope for the best. So now that you know how the assassin's abilities work, how about a recommended perk loadout? Keep in mind, this is how I personally like to play my assassin. Essentially, as the opportunist killer who's all about setting up the right moment for the perfect stab to eliminate an enemy. The final perk decision is yours, however, and you should choose perks that will complement your chosen playstyle as the assassin. That said, here's my personal loadout that I recommend. Super Strike. Perform a stronger stealth attack, dealing 2x normal damage. Experienced Assassin. Stealth attacks are quicker and quieter. Chain Vanish. Successfully assassinating an enemy while vanished reactivates the vanish and refreshes the cooldown. These are the perks that I prefer to take for my assassin. My playstyle, when not running around like a maniac with a katana, is quick and silent. One stab, one kill, move on, and repeat. Experienced Assassin is a key perk for this, as it changes all assassination animations to the ones that are the maxed out one from the story mode when you fully upgrade your Tanto. Essentially, the one-shot neck stab, one shot, one stab, done. Move on. Combined with Chain Vanish for extra stabbing while using your ability, as well as Super Strike to take out or critically wound stronger targets like Oni or Tengu, the Assassin will be a quiet yet lethal force in the battlefield. However, I do also frequently seem to swap out Experienced Assassin for Opportunist these days. With Opportunist, you deal additional bonus assassination damage to staggered enemies, 50% to be precise, which is something you should be, doing very often, staggering enemies that is, in combat to begin with. Plus, with the additional stagger damage from your blow darts or toxic vanish, you'll practically be stunning enemies all the time. I mean, you can take advantage of this very often. Your teammates will also likely be stunning enemies as well, and so you should probably be able to find a moment to take a stab at an enemy quite frequently. And if you find that moment, it will do some serious extra damage. Not only that, but this damage does stack with Super Strike, so if you have Resolve to spare and have a staggered Oni nearby, chances are they can be one-shot very easily. Or, at the very least, brought down to the brink of death so that a teammate can finish them off, such as a samurai who's nearby or a hunter who's got a bead on him. The slightly slower assassination animations are a small price to pay for this kind of insane kill potential. As always, though, the final perk choice is yours and yours alone. Play how you want to play, and fine-tune your loadout to bolster that chosen playstyle. And while we're on the subject of loadouts, let's talk about gear for the assassin. When it comes to katanas, again, it's really all down to personal choice and your preferred playstyle. I will say that I do seem to have more trouble with enemies that have shields or spears as the assassin, so maybe a wind or water katana would be a good idea. Even better if you can get one with both stances, since you can knock enemies down with a charged kick attack for the wind stance, potentially setting up for a stab. Then again, a moon katana is probably never a bad idea, all things considered. Especially since you'll be seeing a lot of Oni at higher levels, and most of them tend to be brutes. In terms of range weapons, the assassin comes with a unique range weapon in the form of the blowgun. With this, you can shoot your enemies with poison darts to deal stagger damage, much like Toxic Vanish, and there's also the secondary type, which applies weaken to enemies. Weaken, if you remember from the Ronin video, will apply an effect that makes it so that enemies will deal less damage and take more damage. You only get 3 of these weakened darts maximum before you have to get a resupply, though, so use them wisely. If you're planning over the blowgun, I recommend getting a hold of the legendary blowgun, Heaven's Sting. Heaven's Sting has the unique effect that has a 20% chance to instantly kill any non-Oni enemy when struck by a dart, so this can be fairly useful for getting some sneaky ranged kills. You can still use a bow if you desire, though the blowgun can land headshots, so you can still help out with the headshot bonus challenges. If you do plan to use Heaven's Sting, though, I recommend saving your weakened darts specifically for Oni enemies, so that way you don't end up accidentally wasting one trying to weaken a normal enemy and then have the effect kick in and it instantly kills them. Certain Ronin bomb packs also come with the perk Assassin Unlock, or you can re-roll them in order to get it, and that does exactly what it things he does. It basically makes it so that the assassin can use the bomb pack as a ranged weapon. This can be fairly useful sometimes, since black powder bombs are a fantastic source of damage, and concussion bombs are good for breaking up enemy guards just a little bit so that you can, get in a right stab. And also, something to keep in mind is that carpet bombing enemies with bombs is a fantastic way to build up resolve fast, which means a lot more super strikes and a lot more shadow strikes. When it comes to ghost weapons, I recommend using a kunai and a smoke bomb. You can't really get more classic shinobi ninja than that, and trust me, the playstyle will practically suit these weapons to a T. A kunai can be used to break through enemy guards or even secure kills on low health enemies, and the smoke bomb is invaluable for setting up a stealth attack on multiple enemies at once, since it forces them to lose sight of you while you're in the smoke. If you manage to get a smoke bomb with the perk that fills the point of resolve when used, that's almost a guaranteed kill with a super strike. In terms of legendary ghost weapons, only two really stand out personally to me as good options. The first is Spirit Kunai. Spirit Kunai is the legendary, well, kunai. And when you land a kill with this weapon, it reduces all your cooldowns by 15 seconds. This goes for class abilities and your ghost weapons, including this one. It's also possible that the lower cooldown can stack if you get multiple kills with the kunai, if you get one kill per blade that you throw. But since I don't have this weapon myself, I can't actually confirm this fact yet. The second one I recommend is actually Lady Sanjo's Surprise, the legendary dirt throw. When you use this weapon, there's a 15% chance that enemies hit with the dirt will hallucinate. If you remember from the story mode, hallucinating enemies will attack anything in sight, much like the frenzy spells from the Elder Scrolls games. In a sense, this can turn an enemy into a temporary ally, as they'll attack their comrades until the effect wears off or they die. Hallucinating enemies are marked by their health bars turning pink while under the effect, and it's probably best that you leave them alone and avoid attacking them, so that way they can, do their job and cause some havoc. Finally, we come to charms. If you're not planning on using the class charm, then I recommend getting a stealth charm for obvious reasons when playing the assassin. If you do have the assassin class charm, though, I highly recommend using it, as it's practically almost guaranteed to give a massive boost to your playstyle as the assassin. Plus, it also comes with two potential perks that you can get unique to this charm that can really turn the tide in battle. The first of these unique perks is Chain Vanish. Now, I know what you're thinking, viewers. Phantasm, isn't that the same perk that you can get in slot 3? The answer is yes, it is. Functionally, this perk is identical to the same perk found in the Techniques tree. What this means is, you can still have the functionality of Chain Vanish without taking the perk, meaning you can use the legendary perk for an extra legendary equip, or Shadow Storm for the improved ultimate. But something to keep in mind here is that this perk actually stacks with the perk in slot 3. So if you have an assassin charm with this perk and have the same perk slotted in the tree, you can get up to 3 vanishes as long as you can secure a kill each time. That's potentially 3 enemies dead with a single ability activation. Plus, if you time it right, you may even be able to get your ability active shortly afterwards, depending on your cooldown. And if you're running group vanish, this means you and all 3 teammates can potentially kill 3 enemies each. That's 12 dead enemies in a single sitting, provided your allies are within range of you when the vanish reactivates and everyone can secure a kill. Frankly, it's nuts. The second unique perk to this class charm that you can get is Hysteria. With this perk, every time you manage a successful assassination, as in when you kill the enemy, you let out a shockwave similar to Toxic Vanish that causes nearby enemies to hallucinate and start attacking each other. Combine this with Chain Vanish, the perk slot, not the charm, and you can render several enemies pretty much useless, as they'll be so focused on killing their friends they won't notice you leaping behind them with a sword driving their skull. Both perks are fantastic, and honestly, this just keeps reinforcing my desire to always use class charms, and to get multiples of them if possible so that I can have one with each perk, like I currently do with my Ronin. As we start wrapping things up, here's a few tips, tricks, and advice I can offer you to moving forward playing as the assassin. The first tip is to not focus on being unseen all the time. Unlike Jin Sakai in the single-player campaign, the assassin isn't meant to be a full-on stealth-only class in Legends, especially not in survival mode. Granted, in the Legends story mode this can work, but in survival there's just too many enemies around at any given time to stay perfectly undetected. And if you're somehow managing that, then that means you're just sitting in a bush while your teammate is getting overrun. Trust me, nobody likes a useless teammate, so, don't do this. The second tip flows in with the last one, and that's not to try and go for sneak attacks all the time, but rather wait for just the right moment to pull it off. Part of playing the assassin involves being patient, waiting for the opportune moment in combat to pull off an assassination. Whether it's waiting for your class ability or smoke bomb to recharge, or getting in position to jump down and stab an enemy distracted by your samurai, it doesn't matter. Just keep fighting and killing enemies, and then when your moment comes, jump on it and strike. The next tip I have to offer is be decisive, but also cautious. The assassin is not the samurai. Unless you're a straight-up god at melee combat, you can't expect a Leroy Jenkins your way to victory with this class. Always be ready to jump on a moment to land a stealth attack, but also don't be afraid to vanish and back off to regroup if things aren't going well. You aren't the samurai, and you don't have a ton of health to work with like he does. Assassins can go down very quickly if you don't know when is the right time to use the Joestar family secret technique. The fourth tip I have is to be a team player. Even if you're running Toxic Vanish and are focused solely on racking up a giant kill count, don't forget to be a team player. Some examples? Consult with your Ronin for healing or ignites, depending on what build they're running. Coordinate with your hunters so they can pick off anyone you can't instantly kill. Or maybe plan with your samurai so that he can cause some havoc for you to slip into and land some decisive strikes. Prepare ahead of time if you've got group vanish and chain vanish so that you and your allies can wipe out an entire squadron if you do this right. And above all else, if you see a teammate get downed and you're nearby, don't be afraid to pop your class ability or smoke bomb to revive them safely. As a Ronin main, I have been saved by friends and teammates playing Assassin through this very method more times than I can count, and trust me, they will thank you for it. The final tip I have is to remember you have a sword, you can still fight. Sure, you may be the stealth class who focuses on key strikes to eliminate enemies in a pinch, but there will be times that your class ability and smoke bombs are on cooldown, and it won't be easy to enter stealth for a sneak attack. So during that time, pull your sword out and hack apart some bad guys. Better to wade into the thick of it and get some kills than just be sitting in a bush twiddling your thumbs while you wait for your cooldown to end. Plus, if you are running Toxic Vanish, as soon as it finishes recharging, you can disappear in a group of enemies and inflict them with poison to open them up for you or your teammates, as well as setting up for stabs. In conclusion, while not as absurdly viable as Jin Sakai was as the Ghost in story mode, the Assassin is still extremely useful for being able to land some serious burst damage to single targets with a well-placed stab. Most teams will definitely say they'd love a Ronin on their side at all times, but a skilled Assassin can be very useful in the overall run of things when it comes to thinning out the herd. Though granted, some of your teammates may get annoyed at you for stealing the kill every now and again, remember that this is a game, we're all here to have fun and win every now and again. So if some kill stealing occurs, well, it's all for the greater good of the team. I hope this guide has given you some insight and tips to get started as the Assassin in Ghost of Tsushima Legends, and who knows, maybe one day I'll see you in one of my matches, streaking through the shadows to land a perfect strike. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you're interested, I recommend checking out some of the other videos on my channel for more Ghost of Tsushima content, as well as content for other games I've played. Thanks for watching, please stay safe, and I will see you in the next video. Take care now.